dear children, how are you? Hope you are doing fine. Are you watching the classes properly? Hope you are doing the homeworks and all. You have to be updated. Okay, I am here again to talk about food. In the last class, we discussed about various types of food. That is, energy giving food, body building food and protective food. Now we will learn about the importance of vitamins and minerals in our daily diet. So mainly there are six types of vitamins. They are vitamin A, vitamin B, vitamin C, vitamin D, vitamin E and vitamin K. And also minerals such as iron, calcium, phosphorus, potassium, sodium, etc. Let's learn more about this in detail. First of all, we will discuss about vitamin A. Vitamin A helps us to get good eyesight and also improves our skin tone. The sources are carrot, oranges, spinach, butter, milk, cheese, etc. So clear? Now we will go through vitamin B. This gives us more energy, aids growth and is good for brain and nerves. Sources are cereals, green vegetables, eggs, meat, etc. Clear about vitamin B? Now we have studied vitamin A and vitamin B. Now we'll go to vitamin C. Vitamin C helps our bones and gums get stronger. The sources are oranges, lemon, melon, berries, tomatoes, mangoes, etc. We should include vitamin C enriched food in our diet to improve our immune system. So, by taking this vitamin C, we can improve our immunity. Next, we will discuss about vitamin D. Vitamin D helps us to get healthy bones and teeth. Major sources are egg yolk, fish, animal liver, etc. And one of the important source of vitamin D is from the sun. When we exposed to the sun, and if we are standing under the sunlight, we are getting vitamin D from the sun's rays. So from the sunlight, we are getting vitamin D. Vitamin D is very necessary for this present corona situation. We can improve our immune power by achieving this vitamin D. So the doctors are suggesting to expose under the sun in the morning time and after 3, we have to get the sunlight. So that vitamin D is getting into our body and it will improve our immune power. So we can fight against these types of diseases. Clear? Next we will see about vitamin E. Vitamin E helps us to get healthy skin, hair, muscles and other organs of the body. The sources are nuts, seeds, spinach, vegetable oil, beet germ, etc. So are you clear about vitamin E? Okay. Now let's see the last one, that is vitamin K. Vitamin K helps us to heal wounds and have a healthy heart and bones. The sources are spinach, the green leafy vegetables, yogurt, cauliflower, cabbage, etc. So now you are clear about all the vitamins. So the vitamin A, which is helping us to get a good eyesight and improves our skin tone. Vitamin B, which improves our brain and nerves. And vitamin C, which is improving our immunity. Vitamin D, which improves our bone and teeth, and as well as it improves our immune system. Vitamin E, which is good for healthy skin, hair, muscles and other organs in our body. And vitamin K, the last one, which is healing our wounds and we will have a healthy heart and bones. Are you clear about vitamins? Okay, now let's see about minerals. Now we will go through certain minerals such as calcium and iron. Do you know what are the food items which is enriched with iron contents? Yes, they are meat, red beans, spinach, dry fruits and this drumstick. These all food items are enriched with iron contents. We should include such type of foods in our diet. Next one is calcium. Calcium helps us to have strong bones and teeth. So when we take calcium enriched food, our bones will become strong and our teeth also become very strong. So do you know what are the calcium enriched food items? Yes, they are milk and dairy products, then the spinach, peas, almonds, etc. So you should include such type of food in your diet to improve your calcium. So now you are clear about the importance of vitamins and minerals. Yes, we should include adequate amount of such type of vitamins and minerals in our daily diet. But please make sure that you should not consume more. Whatever is needed, that much amount only you have to take in your diet. Clear? Now let's learn another important factor, that is water. Water is an important factor in our body, right? We have to drink plenty of water. So what are the benefits of water? Water refreshes our body. Water keeps our eyes moist. Water keeps our skin healthy. And water helps in digestion. And water is an important factor for the proper functioning of our kidneys. So these are the benefits of water. So we should take plenty of water in our daily routine. When you were at school, what were happening after each period? The teachers will say, what they will say? Drink water. That time you will take your water bottle and you will drink water. So now at home also you should practice that. Now it is rainy season, so we will not feel thirsty. So we should stop this drinking habit. But children, don't do that. If it is rainy season also, you have to drink plenty of water. Okay? Otherwise, what will happen? It will lead to dehydration. Do you know what is dehydration? Dehydration is a condition of our body which is not functioning properly due to the lack of water. So, now do you know that what are the sources of water? First one is that the water which we drink. And we are getting water from the fruits which we eat, milk, soups, juices and other drinks. So these all are the sources of water. So children, now are you clear about the importance of water? So water is a necessary factor in our life. We have to drink plenty of water. Now we understood about various types of food and the importance of vitamins and minerals in our body. And also we have gone through the importance of water. So are you clear about all the topics? Yes? So now we will see in the next class. Till then, bye.